comic book fans, welcome to a special edition of Cammy's Comic Corner, the kick-ass episode. I'm your host, as always, Cammy. Now, I'm going to review in this episode the comic book from Icon, and then give my thoughts on the movie, and you know, how that transitioned from page to screen. So first off, let me tell you a little bit about Kick-Ass, if you've been living under a rock for the past couple months. It started out in July of 2008, and I say 2008 because you think of, oh, okay, cool, whatever. Four issues came out in 2008, and then three in 2009, and then the final issue came out March 2010. So it's been kind of a work in progress, being it's written by Mark Miller and art by John Romita Jr. And so we follow the whole story revolves around this kid. His name is Dave Lazuski. And he's just not a jock, he's not your typical geek, he likes comic books. He exists, no one really takes notice of him. But his big question is, you know, you see all these people dressing up in the comics and kicking ass and whatnot, why doesn't anyone want to be Spider-Man and everyone wants to be Paris Hilton instead? He doesn't get that. He thinks being a superhero would be cool, so sure enough, he buys a wetsuit, goes out and tries to fight crime. Well, that kind of doesn't work out for him, as he pretty much loses 6 months of his life to surgeries, trauma care, trying to get back onto the road to recovery. He even has metal plates in his skull now because he took a beating so badly. Well, afterwards, he swears he's never going to do it again, but then he kind of figures out that, well, he doesn't figure out, he becomes a celebrity overnight after he's helping this poor guy, trying to get away from the mob, and he just he takes out his nightsticks and starts wailing around, you know, kicking, trying to just get all these mobsters away. And sure enough, he does. You know, he's a bloody pulp again, but he's managed to make them go away, and someone catches it up on the cell phone, sends it to YouTube, and then he's an instant celebrity. Well, because of this, everyone else starts taking a page out of his book. Like, well, if this kid can do it, I can do it. And then you get a whole array of new characters, including this one duo named Big Daddy and Hit Girl. We're introduced to them during a call. Kick-Ass goes to this apartment to tell this one guy, hey, this girl says you're not leaving her alone, you should leave her alone. He's about to get kicked, you know, ass kicked again, but then Hit Girl comes to the rescue, and she's like this 10-year-old girl flying around with samurai swords and, you know, killing people left and right with guns. She'll blow your mind. And literally, she'll blow your mind. Bam! And so they team up. They're a little bit more badass than what Kick-Ass is used to. He's used to, you know, going into burning buildings to save kittens, not taking on the mob. But we're introduced to another character named Red Mist. They become palsy-wowsy. And then he decides, hey, you know, it'd be cool if we all got together, made our own little Justice League of sorts. Big Daddy and Hit Girl are like, yeah, sure, whatever. We need more people to help us take down the mob anyway. And then we find out that Red Mist is actually the big mob boss's son. He's in on the plan, and he's trapped them all here. You think you killed Hit Girl. They torture Kick-Ass and Big Daddy before they're about to kill him. And then we discover that the origin story of Big Daddy, which we all thought was like Frank Castle, where he was in the police, mobsters murdered his wife and he swore vengeance. No, he's actually an accountant. And he's been financing their whole adventures by selling off his old number one issues of comic books, like the, you know, First Avengers, Spider-Man's, Incredible Hulk's, whatnot. This guy was a geek at heart, saw what Kick-Ass was doing and said, you know what, I want to do that too. And why the mob? They needed a villain. So unfortunately, a Big Daddy dies, but Hit Girl gets her revenge on them, slicing and dicing left and right. Finally makes it up to the penthouse, the big boss, kills him. And one of the most saddest scenes is after she's done killing everybody, she goes, you know, I just lost my dad, you know, please comfort me or whatnot. And then you see that little girl that should have been, instead of this Hit Girl, as it were. But so in the end, Red Mist survives, and that's going to make for a sequel. And pretty much is a badass title. You got some humor in it, like at one point, because Kick-Ass is beaten up, he is able to get his costume off in time before the ambulance picks him up, and so he's naked on the streets when they pick him up, so rumors go around at school that he's gay. And so then this one girl that he really likes starts taking interest in him because she needs a gay best friend. And when he tells her this at the end, that he's not actually gay, She feels deceived that she was tricked and gets her boyfriend to go beat him up. So it's a funny ending because it's like, that's more realistic. Now on to the movie. The movie stars Aaron Johnson as Kick-Ass, Christopher Mintz-Plasse as Red Mist, or McLovin, if you will, Chloe Moretz as Hit Girl, Nicolas Cage as Big Daddy, and Mark Strong as D'Amico, Frank D'Amico, who is the head mob boss. I had fun at this movie. It was fun. It was like Kill Bill meets, you know, insert whatever X-Men or whatever comic book you like here. It was bloody. It was just action-packed throughout. It should have been, if anything, called Hit Girl, the movie at one point, because she gets a lot more playing time in the movie than she did the comic book. Now, some of the things that they changed up, you know, because it's Hollywood, they're going to change up a comic book movie. The gay friend, that happens still, only at the end when he reveals to her that he's not gay, she accepts him, and then they're a loving couple, as it were. That kind of made me go, okay, I didn't really care for that. Whatever. The origin of Big Daddy and Hit Girl. He's actually a police officer in the movie, and his partner, he was partners with this one guy, and when he dies, Hit Girl goes to the partner instead. So I didn't like that. I liked the whole geeky aspect of it, where he was selling his comic books to fund what he really liked. And then you have, you know, various other things, like a jetpack comes into play at one point, and then the story's kind of twisted at other parts. But basically, if you like the book, you'll like the movie. I've heard friends tell me that they like the movie more than the actual comic book. I personally don't see that, but it was still a fun movie nonetheless. If anything, it totally does set it up for a sequel, and knowing Mark Miller, we're probably going to get the sequel of the movie before we get the sequel of the comic book series. That's another thing that, like, as much as I adore this series, both movie and comic book, the thing that just really kind of ticked me off was Mark Miller had this whole comic book script, you know, written out in his head and whatnot, and the movie was in the can. It was wrapped and ready to go before the last issue ever came out, you know, earlier this year. So, you know, priorities. I understand that, you know, he's a creator and he needs to make money somehow. And then he saw how successful Wanted was at the box office and said, let me see what else I can put together here. So we have Nemesis coming up. That's the next thing after Kick-Ass. So, you know, keep in mind, if you want more Kick-Ass type stories, that's pretty much on the horizon. But good luck waiting a couple years for that to eventually come out too. So that does it for the Kick-Ass episode. If you want more Kami's Comic Corner goodness, where I talk about other comic book movies and whatnot, head on over to www.kamiescomiccorner.com. From there, you can subscribe to us on the iTunes, RSS feed, go chat on the forums, tell me what you thought of Kick-Ass. Also, if you like any of the Kick-Ass t-shirts that you usually see me wearing, head on over to deadlinegraphics.net. Kelly does the best in custom-made t-shirts, whether it's video games, comic books, or insert your logo here. One name that I trust, deadlinegraphics.net. And also, big shout-out to Rising Sun Creations at rsc-online.com. They specialize in the best of U.S. comic books, manga, and collectible toys imported straight from Japan. And guess what? They do have Kick-Ass, the trade, and single issues at their physical store and online store at rsc-online.com. Well, all this talk of being a vigilante is getting me a little worked up and excited. So if you don't mind, I need to go patrol the streets before bed tonight. You know what Kick-Ass is. Now, ladies and gentlemen, meet Badass. Take it easy, motherfuckers.